The entity lifecycle model is one of the core concepts of JPA and all its implementations. Even though it's not directly visible when working with JPA's entity manager, it affects all operations you perform. The different states of the model define how your persistence provider, for example Hibernate, handles your entity objects. This includes if it loads it from the database or gets it from an internal cache, if it persists changes, and if it removes the entity. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. Welcome to this in-depth guide to the entity lifecycle model in JPA and Hibernate. I will explain all the different lifecycle states and the SQA statements they trigger. So be sure to stay till the end. But before we start, if you're new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. Okay, before we talk about the different lifecycle states, I need to explain a concept called persistence context. It's one of the main concepts in JPA. You can think of it as a set of all entity objects that you use in your current use case. Each of them represents a record in the database. The specification defines it as follows. A persistence context is a set of entity instances in which for any persistence entity identity, there is a unique entity instance. Within the persistence context, the entity instances and their lifecycle are managed. Based on this definition, we can now talk about the lifecycle model. The lifecycle model consists of the four states: transient, managed, removed, and detached. The lifecycle state of a newly instantiated entity object is called transient. The entity hasn't been persisted yet, so it doesn't represent any database record. Your persistence context doesn't know about your newly instantiated object. Because of that, it doesn't automatically perform an SQL insert statement or track any changes. As long as your entity object is in the lifecycle state transient, you can think of it as a basic Java object without any connection to the database and any JPA-specific functionality. That changes when you provide it to the entity manager persist method. The entity object then changes its lifecycle state to managed and gets attached to the current persistence context. All entity objects attached to the current persistence context are in the lifecycle state managed. That means that your persistence provider, for example Hibernate, will detect any changes on the objects and generate the required SQL insert or update statements when it flushes the persistence context. There are different ways to get an entity to the lifecycle state managed. You can call the entity manager persist method with a new entity object. You can load an entity object from the database using the entity manager find method, a JPQA query, a criteria query, or a native SQA query. You can merge a detached entity by calling the entity manager merge method or update it by calling the update method on your Hibernate session. An entity that was previously managed but is no longer attached to the current persistence context is in the lifecycle state detached. An entity gets detached when you close the persistence context. That typically happens after a request got processed. Then the database transaction gets committed, the persistence context gets closed, and the entity object gets returned to the caller. The caller then retrieves an entity object in the lifecycle state detached. You can also programmatically detach an entity by calling the detach method on the entity manager. There are only very few performance tuning reasons to detach a managed entity. If you decide to detach an entity, you should first flush the persistence context to avoid losing any pending changes. You can reattach an entity by calling the update method on your Hibernate session or the merge method on the entity manager. There are a few subtle differences between these operations that I explained in great detail in my video What's the difference between persist, save, merge, and update? And which one should you use? In both cases, the entity changes its lifecycle state to managed. When you call the remove method on your entity manager, the map database record doesn't get removed immediately. The entity object only changes its lifecycle state to removed. During the next flush operation, Hibernate will generate an SQL delete statement to remove the record from the database table. All entity operations are based on JPA's lifecycle model. It consists of four states, which define how your persistence provider handles the entity object. New entities that are not attached to the current persistence context are in the state transient. If you call the persist method on the entity manager with a new entity object or read an existing record from the database, the entity object is in the managed state. It's connected to the current persistence context. Your persistence context will generate the required SQL insert and update statement to persist the current state of the object. Entities in the state removed are scheduled for removal. The persistence provider will generate and execute the required SQL delete statement during the next flush operation. If a previously managed entity is no longer associated with an active persistence context, it has the lifecycle state detached. Changes to such an entity object will not be persisted in the database. If you want to learn more about JPA's basic concepts and how to use them to implement your persistence layer, you should enroll in my JPA for Beginners online course. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!